Watch us on YouTube and Facebook. Listen to our podcast and support us on Patreon. Thanks for stopping by.
First hour. This god enters into the earth through the hall of the horizon of Amentet. There are 120 Atru to journey over in this hall before a man arrives at the gods of the Tuat. The name of the first field of the Tuat is Net-Ra. He allots fields to the gods who are in following, and he begins to send forth words to work out the plans of the divine beings of the Tuat in respect of this field. Whosoever shall have these images made according to the similitude, which is an aiment of the Tuat, whosoever shall know these similitudes, the copies of this great god himself, they shall act as magical protectors for him upon earth regularly and unfailingly, and they shall act as magical protectors for him in the great Tuat. Ushemet Hadakefti Ra is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god through this hall. The second hour. This great god afterward takes up his position in Enist, which is 309 Atru in length, and 120 Atru in width. The name of the gods who are in this field is, Bayatuadi. Whosoever know their names shall have his existence with them, and unto him shall this great god allot fields in the place wherein they are in the field of Enz. He shall stand up with the gods who stand up. He shall travel on in the following of this great god. He shall enter into the earth. He shall force a way through the Tuat. He shall cleave a passage through the tresses of the gods with flowing hair. He shall travel on by the eater of the ass after the emptying of the lands. He shall eat bread cakes in the boat of the earth, and there shall be given unto him the forepart of Tituba. Whosoever shall have made in writing similitudes of the Bayatuadi in the forms in which they are an aiment of the Tuat, now the beginning of such representations should be from Amentet, and whosoever shall make offerings unto them upon the earth in their names shall act as magical protectors to that person upon earth, regularly and unfailingly. And whosoever shall know the words which the gods of the Tuat speak to this god, and the words which are said by him to them when he is approaching the gods of the Tuat, shall act as magical protectors to him that know them upon the earth, regularly and unfailingly. Shisat Maket Nebes is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god through this field. The third hour. This great god afterward takes up his position in the fields of the Peru gods, and this great god paddles his way over the stream of Osiris in sailing up this field, which is 309 Atra long, and 120 Atra wide. This great god utters words to those who are in the following of Osiris to this city, and he allots unto them estates which are situated in this field. Bayashatayu is the name of the gods who are in this field, and whosoever know their names upon the earth shall be able to approach to the place where Osiris is, and there shall be given unto him water for his field. Net-Neb-Wa Keeper Watu is the name of this field. Whosoever shall know these hidden similitudes of the hidden souls in the correct forms wherein they are depicted in aiment of the Tuat, now the beginning of such representations should be from Amentet, and shall act as magical protectors to that man upon earth, in Neterkert, regularly and unfailingly. Whosoever know these when he is making his journey past them shall escape from their roaring, and he shall not fall into their furnaces. Whosoever know this, when he is keeping ward over his seat, his bread cake shall be with Ra, and whosoever know this, being soul spirit, shall have the mastery over his legs, and shall never enter into the place of destruction, but he shall come forth with his attributes, and shall snuff the air for his hour. Then Tent Bayu is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god through this field. The fourth hour. The majesty of this great god, having been towed along, afterward takes up his position in the secret circle of Amentet, and he performs the affairs of the gods of the Tuat, who are therein through his voice, but he sees them not. Ankh-Khepru is the name of the gate of this circle. Amit-Satho is the name of this circle. Whosoever knows this representation of the hidden roads of Ristetet, and the holy paths of the Amahet, and the secret doors, which are in the land of Seeker, the god who is upon his sand, shall be in the condition of him that eat the bread cakes which are for the mouth of the living gods in the temple of Tem. Whosoever know this shall be in the condition of him that is mod on the ways, and he shall journey over the roads of Resetho, and he shall see the representations of the Amahet. Ert-Em-Sekhemos set is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god. The fifth hour. This great god is towed along over the ways of Maat of the Tuat through the upper half of this secret circle of the god-seeker, who is upon his sand, and he neither looks upon nor gazes at the secret figure of the earth which contain the flesh of this god. The gods who are in this god hear the words of Ra, who cries unto them from where this god is. Ahanetaru is the name of the door. Ament is the name of the circle of this god, the secret path of Amentet, and the doors of the hidden palace, and the holy place of the land of seeker flesh, members, and body, in the divine form which they had at first. Biwamutuit is the name of the gods who are in this circle. Their forms who are in their hour, and their secret shapes neither know, nor look upon, nor see this image of seeker himself. Whosoever shall make these representations according to the image, which is in writing in the hidden places of the Tuat, at the south of the hidden palace, and whosoever shall know them shall be at peace, and his soul shall unite itself to the offerings of Seeker, and the goddess Kemet shall not hack his body in pieces, and he shall go on his way towards her in peace. Whosoever shall make offerings to these gods upon earth these offerings, I say, shall act as magical protectors to that man upon earth, and in Netterkurt, regularly and unfailingly. Semherb-Wyas is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god through this field. The sixth hour. The majesty of this great god takes up his position in the stream of Net-Mutuashu, and he sends forth words to the gods who are therein, and he commands that they have the mastery over their divine offerings in this city. He makes his way through this field, being provided with his boat, and he sets apart by his words the estates which are their offerings in this city, and he gives to them water for their lakes, and travels through the Tuat every day. Septmetu is the name of the door of this city. The secret roads of Amentet, and the manner wherein this great god is being rowed along over the water therein in his boat to perform the plans of the gods of the Tuat, the gathering together by their names, the manifestations of their shapes, and secret hours, such are the things of which the secret representation of the Tuat is not known to men and women. Whosoever shall make this image in writing, according to the representation of the same, which is in the hidden things of the Tuat, at the south of the hidden palace, and whosoever shall know them shall be in the condition of one who award offerings in abundance in the Tuat, and he shall be united to the offerings of the gods who are in the following of Osiris, and his parents shall make the offerings which are obligatory on the earth. The majesty of this great god send forth words, and he gives divine offerings to the Tuat, and he stands up by them, and they see him, and they have dominion over their fields, and the gifts made to them, and they effect their transformations because of the words which this great god has spoken unto them. Metchet-Netuashu is the name of this field, which is the road of the boat of Ra. Mesperit-Armat is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god through this country. The seventh hour. The majesty of this great god takes up his position in the secret place of Osiris, and the majesty of this great god sends forth words to the gods who dwell therein. This god makes to himself other forms for this hidden place to drive out of his path the serpent fiend Apep through the words of power of Isis, and the words of power of Semsu. Vertiasar is the name of the gate of this city through which this god passes. Tefet Sheda is the name of this city. This great god makes his way over the road of Ament in the holy boat, and he passes in it over this road which is without water, without being towed along. He makes his way through the words of power of Isis, and through the words of power of Semsu, and the utterances of this great god himself act as magical protectors, and perform the slaughters of Apep and the Tuat, in this circle, in his windings in the sky. Whosoever shall make these images according to the similitudes, which are in writing at the northern side of the hidden palace in the Tuat, they shall act as magical protectors for him that make them in heaven and earth. And whosoever know them shall be a soul of souls with Ra. And whosoever shall make the words of power of Isis, and the words of power of Semsu, shall drive back the Apep of Ra in Amentet. Whosoever shall do this in the hidden palace of the Tuat, and upon the earth, the same. whosoever know this shall be in the boat of Ra, both in heaven and upon the earth. But he that has no knowledge of this representation shall not know how to drive back Nahar-Ra. Now the ridge of the earth of Nahar-Ra in the Tuat is 450 cubits in length, and he fills it with the undulations of his body. The regions which belong to him are made for him, and the great God does not make his way over him, when he makes him turn aside out of the way for him, from the secret place of Osiris, when this God makes his way through this city in the form of a serpent Mehen. Whosoever shall know this upon the earth, the serpent Nahar-Ra shall not drink his water, and the soul of him that know it shall not be entreated evil by the gods who are in this circle, and whosoever knoweth the crocodile of Shau shall not devour his soul. Kaseth Hai Hesek Nahar-Ra is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god through this circle. The eighth hour. When the majesty of this great god has taken up his position in the secret circles of those who are in their sand, he sends forth words to them from out of his boat, and the gods tow him along within the holy embrace of the serpent Mehen. Aha in Erdef is the name of the gate of this city. Tebet Neter is said is the name of this city. As for the secret circle of Amentet, this great god makes his way over it in his boat, through the towing of the gods who are in the Tuat. Whosoever shall make an image of these things according to the similitude, which is in writing on the north wall of the hidden palace in the Tuat, and whosoever shall know them by their names, shall be in the condition of one who is fully provided with swathing on the earth, and shall never be repulsed at the secret gates, and have abundant offerings in the great funeral hall regularly and unfailingly for millions of years. Net-Usha is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god. The ninth hour. When the majesty of this great god has taken up his position in this circle, he sends forth words from his boat to the gods who dwell therein, and the sailors join the boat of this great god in this city. Saqeb is the name of the gate of this city through which this great god passes to take up his position on the stream which is in this city. Besaru is the name of the city, which is the secret circle of Amentet, wherein this great god and his sailors take up their positions in the Tuat. Whosoever make an image of these things and their names according to the similitudes which are in writing on the east of the hidden palace of the Tuat, and whosoever know their names upon the earth and their habitations in Amentet, shall rest in his habitation in the Tuat, and he shall stand up among the lords of the provisions of the gods, and his voice shall be mocked before the Chacha beings on the day of the reckoning of Pharaoh. And these things shall act as magical protectors to him that know them upon the earth. Mak Nebes is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god in this circle. The tenth hour. The majesty of this great god takes up his position in this circle, and he sends forth words to the gods who are in it. Akeraru Mesaru is the name of the gate of this city through which this great god passes. Mech Kayutabu is the name of this city. The secret circle of Amentet where Kepra joins himself before Ra, and the gods, the spirits, and the dead cry out over the secret representations of Akert. Whosoever shall make these images according to the figures which are depicted on the east of Ament, and whosoever know them by their names shall journey in the Tuat, and shall travel through it, and not be driven back, and shall flourish with Ra. Tentanet Hesk Kakabu is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god through the secret ways of this city. The 11th hour. The majesty of this great god takes up his position in this circle, and he sends forth words to the gods who are therein. Sekhen Tuashu is the name of the gate of this city through which this great god passes. Re Enkerut Apt Kot is the name of this city. The secret circle of the Tuat in which this great god passes on his way, and comes forth at the eastern mountain of the sky, the eater of eternity. The form there is in the presence of the serpent Petra, which dwell in this city, and they place themselves in the train of Ra when the birth of Keeper upon earth is about to take place. Whosoever shall make an image according to the figures which are depicted on the east of the palace of Ament in the hidden of the Tuat, and whosoever know them shall be in the position that divide his offering, and is a spirit who is suitably equipped both in heaven and upon the earth, regularly and unceasingly. Sebet Nebwa Kasef Cbum Perdef is the name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god in this circle. the 12th hour. The majesty of this great god takes up his position in this circle at the limits of the thick darkness, and this great god is born under the form of Kepra in this circle. The gods Nu, Amli, Hat, and Hehat are in this circle at the birth of this great god, when he makes his appearance from the Tuat, and takes up his place in the Metet boat, and rises from between the thighs of the goddess Nut. Then in Neteru is the name of the gate of the city. Keeper Kikue Kalmesti is the name of the city. The secret circle of the Tuat, where this great god is born, when he makes his appearance in Nu, and takes up his place in the body of Nut. Whosoever shall make an image according to the figures, which are depicted on the east of the palace of Amint of the Tuat, they shall be magical protectors to him that know them both in heaven and on earth. At this point the light begins, and it is the end of the thick darkness, which Ra travels through in Amentet, and of the secret matters which this great god performed therein. He who has no knowledge of the whole or part of the secret representations of the Tuat shall be condemned to destruction. Whosoever shall make an image of these according to this copy of what is in the Amint of the Tuat cannot be looked at or seen, and whosoever shall know these secret images shall be in the condition of the spirit who is equipped, and shall come forth, and shall descend into the Tuat, and shall hold converse with the men and women who live regularly and unfailingly, millions of times. I am Mespa, I am your son, O Osiris, King, Lord of the Two Lands, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, son of the sun, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, and I have come so that I may be among those who protect you. I intend to flourish your house, which shall be doubly established, by the command of Ta, and by the command of Ra himself. I am Anpu, who dwells in the funeral chest. Mother Isis descends for me, Osiris, King Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, son of the sun, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, from him that works against me. I am Twamatef, I am your son Horus, I love you, and I have come to avenge you, Osiris, upon him that would work his wickedness upon you, and I will set him under your feet forever, Osiris, King, Lord of the Two Lands, Menmot-Ra, son of the sun, from his body, loving him, Lord of Crowns Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, before the great god. Ra shall live, and the tortoise dies. Strong are the members of Osiris, King Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, for Kebsenuf guards them. Ra shall live, and the tortoise dies. In a sound state is he who is in the sarcophagus, in a sound state is he who is in the sarcophagus, that is to say, the son of the sun, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot. O Osiris, King, Lord of the Two Lands, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, who loves me, I give you purity on the earth, and splendor in the heavens, and I give unto you, your head forever. This is my son, Osiris, King, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot. His father Shu loves him, and his mother Nut loves him, Osiris, son of Ra, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot. I am happy. I have come that I might be among those who protect you. I bind together for you, your head, and members, smiting down for you, your enemies beneath you, and I give you your head, Osiris, King, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, son of Ra, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot. I am Anpu, the governor of the divine house. Osiris, King, Lord of the Two Lands, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, son of the sun, from his body, the Lord of Crowns, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, the Shena beings go round about you, and your members remain uninjured, Osiris, King, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot forever. I am your son, I have come so that I might be among those who protect you. I gather together for you your bones, and I piece together for you your limbs. I bring unto you your heart, and I set it upon its seat in your body. I make to flourish for you your house after you, who lives forever. Ra shall live, and the tortoise dies. Let the bones of Osiris enter, King Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, the son of the sun, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, let them enter into their foundations. Pure is the dead body which is in the earth, and pure are the bones of Osiris, King Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, like Ra forever. The words of Osiris the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, the son of Ra, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat, who says, O goddess Nut, support me, for I am your son. Destroy my defects of immobility, and those who produce them. This son Osiris, the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, the son of Ra, from his body, who loves him, the lord of crowns, Osiris, Seti Marinta. This son Menmat Ra, who loves me. I have given him purity upon the earth, and glory in heaven, Osiris, king, the lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, the son of Ra, the lover of Nut, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat, before the lords of the Tuat. Osiris, king, lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, the son of Ra, from his body, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat. Your mother Nut puts forth two hands and arms over you, Osiris, king, lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, son of Ra, whom he loves, lord of diadems, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat. Your mother Nut has added the magical powers which are yours, and you are in her arms and shall never die. Lifted and driven away are the calamities, and they shall never come to or draw near you, Osiris, king, the lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat. Horus has taken his stand behind you, Osiris, son of Ra, lord of diadems, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat, for your mother Nut has come to you, she has purified you, united herself to you, she has supplied you as a god, and you are alive and established among the gods. I have endowed him with a soul, I have endowed him with a spirit, and I have given him power in the body of his mother Tefnut, I who was never brought forth. I have come, and I have united myself to Osiris, the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, the son of Ra, the lord of diadems, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat, with life, stability, and power. He shall not die. I am Nut of the mighty heart, and I took up my being in the body of my mother Tefnut in my name of Nut. Over my mother, none has gained mastery. I have filled every place with my beneficence, and I have led captive the whole earth. I have led captive the south and the north, and I have gathered together the things which are into my arms to vivify Osiris, the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, the son of the sun, from his body, the lover of Seeker, the lord of diadems, the governor whose heart is glad, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat. His soul shall live forever. Nut, raise me up. I am your son, set free him whose heart is at rest from that which makes it still. Osiris, the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, the son of the sun, loving him, Seti Marinta. Homage to you, lords of Mat, who are free from iniquity, who exist and live forever, and to the double henti period of everlastingness, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, the son of the sun, from his body, loving him, the lord of diadems, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat, before you have become a coup in his attributes, he has gained the mastery through his words of power, and he is laden with his splendors. Deliver Osiris, the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, the son of the sun, the lord of diadems, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat, from the crocodile of this pool of Mati. He has his mouth, let him speak therewith. Let there be granted unto him broad-handedness in your presence, because I know you, and I know your names. I know this great god unto whose nostrils you present offerings of Shafo. Rekem is his name. He makes a way through the eastern horizon of heaven. Rekem departs and I also depart. He is strong, and I am strong. Let me not be destroyed in the Mesket chamber. Let not the Seba fiends gain mastery over me. Drive not me away from your gates, and shut not fast your arms against Osiris, the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmat Ra, whose word is Mat, the son of the sun, from his body, loving him, the lord of diadems, Seti Marinta, whose word is Mat, because bread is in the city of Pi, and my ale is in the city of Tep, and my arms are united in the divine house which my father has given to me. He has established for me a house in the high place of the lands, and there are wheat and barley therein, the quantity of which is unknown. The son of my body acts for me there as Kerheb. grant you unto me sepulchral offerings of incense, and myrrh unguent, and all beautiful and pure things of every kind whereon the god live. Osiris, the king, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, the son of the sun, from his body, loving him, the lord of diadems, the ruler of the joy of heart, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, exist forever in all the transformations which it pleases. He floats down the river, he sails up into Sekhetaru, he reaches Sekhet-Hetep. I am the double lion god. Ward off that destroyer from my father Osiris, the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, and let his divine protection be under my legs, and let them live. Strengthen Osiris, son of the sun, lord of diadems, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, with your hand. Grasp him with your hand, let him enter your hand, let him enter your hand, Osiris, king, lord of the two lands, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, you shall not perish. Nut comes and she fashions you as the great fashioner, and you shall never decay. She fashions you, she turns your weakness into strength, she gathers together your members, she brings your heart into your body, and she placed you at the head of the living doubles, Osiris, king, lord of the two lands, Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, before the beautiful god, the lord of Ta-Chesert. Hail, you gods who bring Anu, you gods who run Pihu, you who dwell in his embrace, you great god, grant you that may come unto me my soul from wheresoever it may be. If it would delay, then let my soul be brought unto me from wheresoever it may be, for you shalt find the eye of Horus standing by you like those watchful gods. If it lies down, let it lie down in Anu, the land where souls are joined to their bodies in thousands. Let my soul be brought unto me from wheresoever it may be. Make you strong, guardian of sky and earth, this my soul. If it would tarry, do you cause the soul to see its body, and you shall find the eye of Horus standing by you even as do those gods who watch. Hail, you gods who tow along the boat of the Lord of millions of years, who bring into the upper regions of the Tuat, who make it pass over Nut, and who make the soul enter into its Sahu. Let your hands be full of weapons, and grasp them, and make them sharp, and hold chains in readiness to destroy the serpent enemy. Let the boat rejoice, and let the great god pass on in peace, and behold, grant that the soul of Osiris, King Menmot-Ra, whose word is Mot, may emerge from the thighs in the eastern horizon of heaven, forever and forever. Shena beings, go behind me, and let not my members be without strength. Nut, lift me up. I am your son. Do away that which make me to be without motion. Osiris, the king, the lord of the two lands, Menmot-Ra-Ra, whose word is Mot, the soil or the sun, from his body, loving him, the lord or diadems, Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, I have given you your head to be on your body, and all the members of him that is Seti-Merin-Ta, whose word is Mot, shall never lack strength. Ra says to the mountain, send forth light, mountain. Let radiance arise from that which has devoured me, and which has slain men, and is filled with the slaughter of the gods. Breath to you, who dwell in the light in your habitations, my splendors shall be to you. I have decreed their slaughter, and they have slaughtered everything that exists. I have hidden you from those who are upon the earth, restoring the crown to those who are on the mountain. Let this jackal-headed scepter emit the words of this great god, who joined together his members. Come men unto us, you, from whom we have come forth. Cries of joy are to you, you who are in your disk, you great god whose forms are manifold. Their provisions of bread cakes and beer. These gods have come into being from Ra, and his substance, and have emerged from his eye. He has decreed for them a place, the hidden mountain, which consume men, gods, all cattle, and all reptiles created by this great god. This great god has decreed the plans thereof having made to spring up in the earth which he created. The hidden place. Those who have consumed the men, gods, all the cattle, and all reptiles which this great god hath created. This great god has decreed plans for them after he made them spring up in the land which he created in the Amentet. He who is over this door open to Ra, Sa says to Sat-Set, open your door to Ra, throw your door wide open to Kuti. The hidden abode is in darkness, so that the transformations of this god may take place. This portal is closed after this god has entered it, and there is a lamentation on the part of those who are in their mountain when they hear this door shut. This great god journeys along the roads of the Tuat. This god is drawn by the gods of the Tuat in the earth to work out designs therein, to weigh words and deeds in aiment, to magnify the great god above the little god among the gods who are in the Tuat, to place the Ku upon their thrones, and the damned to where they have been condemned in the judgment, to destroy their bodies by an evil death. Grant ye to me that I may restore the tiara, and that I may have possession of my shrine which is in the earth. Let Sa and Hika unite themselves to me for the working out of plans for you, and for making to come into being their attributes you have what is yours. Isis has made the wind peaceful, and offerings are there. None shut the door against you, and the damned do not enter after you. That which belonged to you is to you. There is darkness on the road of the Tuat. Let the doors which are closed be opened, let the earth open, so that the gods may draw along him that has created them. Their food is of funeral offerings, their drink is from their cool waters, and their hands are on meat offerings among the occult regions of Aiment. These have worshipped Ra upon the earth, who uttered words of power against Apep, who made their offerings unto him, and who burnt incense to their gods on their behalf, after their offerings. They have gained possession of their cool waters, and they receive their meat, and they eat of their offerings in the gateway of him whose name is hidden. Their meat is by the gateway, and their offerings are with him. Who is therein? Your offerings are yours, you have power over your cool waters, your souls shall never be hacked to pieces, your meat shall never fail, you who praised me, and have vanquished a pet for me. They spoke truth upon the earth, and were not addicted to an evil thought about the gods. They make their invocations in this gateway, they live upon Mott, and their cool waters are in their cisterns. Truth is yours, live on your food. You are truth, and they have power over their cool waters, which are waters of fire to those who have guilt and sin. Tem works on behalf of Ra, glorifying the god, singing praises to his soul, and distributing evil things to his enemies. The word of my father Ra is right against you, and my word is right against you. I am the son who proceed from his father, and I am the father who proceed from his son. You are fettered and tied with a strong cord, and I have sent forth the decree that you should be bound in fetters. Your arms shall never be opened. Ra pronounces the formula against you. His soul is prepared to attack you. My father has gained mastery over you, and his soul utters words against you. Your evil deeds have turned against you. Your plotting have come upon you. Your abominable acts have recoiled upon you. Your destinies are for evil, and your doom has been decreed before Ra. Your unjust and perverted judgments are upon yourselves, and the wickedness of your words of cursing is upon you. Evil is the doom which has been decreed for you before my father. It is you who have committed sins, who have wrought iniquity in the great hall. Your corruptible bodies shall be cut in pieces, and your souls shall have no existence, and you shall never again see Ra with his attributes as he journey in the hidden land. Hail, Ra! Adored be Ra! Your enemies are in the place of destruction. This god comes to this gateway to enter. The gods who are therein acclaim this great god. Let this gateway open to Kuti, and let the doors be open to him in heaven. Come then, traveler who journey in Amentet. He who is over this door open to Ra. Open your gate to Ra, unfold your door to Kuti. He shall illumine the darkness, and he shall force a way for the light in the habitation which is hidden. This door closes after the great god has entered it, and there is lamentation to those who are in their gateway when they hear this door close upon them. This great god is towed along by the gods of the Tuat, and this great god advances to the boat of the earth, which is the bark of the gods. Hail, you gods who bear up his boat of the earth, and who lift the bark of the Tuat, may there be a support to your forms and light to your bark. Holy is he who is in the boat of the earth. I make to go back the bark of the Tuat, which bear my forms, and I travel into the hidden habitation to perform the plans which are carried out therein. Praised be the soul which the double bull has swallowed, and let the god be at peace with that which he has created. Praised be Ra, whose soul has been absorbed by the earth god. Praised be the gods of Ra who has rested therein. This bode of its Tuat rejoice, and there are cries from them after Ra hath passed them as he journeys on his way. Their offerings are the plants of the year, and their offerings are given to them when they hear the words of those who draw along this great god. Tau of the earth, whose duty it is to stand near his habitation, whose heads are uncovered, and whose arms are hidden, may there be air to your nostrils, and may your funeral swathing be burst open, and may you have the mastery over your meats, and may you have peace in that which I have created. Their food is of bread cakes, and their bread is made of the red grain. The draughts which they drink are of cool water, and their meat is given to them because of the whiteness of their apparel in the Tuat. Those in their shrines are the members of the god whose shrines the serpent Seti guard. Open your shrines, so that my radiance may penetrate the darkness in which you're in. I found you weeping and lamenting, with your shrines tightly closed, but air shall be given to your nostrils, and I have decreed that you shall have an abundance of overflowing. Hail, Ra, come into our lake, great god who never fails. The Shema gods who are before and behind him pay homage and rejoice in Ra when he traverses their region, and when the great god journeys through the secret place. Their food consists of loaves of bread, their drink is made from the red barley, their cool waters come from their cisterns, and the serpent of fire, Seti, gives them the things whereon they live there. The door which shut them in closes after this god has passed through their midst, and they utter cries of grief when they hear their doors shut upon them. The lake of water which is in the Tuat, and is surrounded by the gods who are arrayed in apparel, and who have heads uncovered. This lake is filled with green herbs. The water of this lake is boiling, and the birds take to flight when they see the waters, and when they smell the fœtid smell in it. Gods whose duty is to guard the green herbs of your lake, whose heads are uncovered, and whose limbs are covered with garments, may there be air to your nostrils, and may offerings be made to you of the green herbs, and may your meat be from your lake. The water shall be yours, but to you, it shall not be boiling, and the heat shall not be on your bodies. Come unto us, who sail in your boat, whose eye is of blazing fire which consume, and has a pupil which send forth light. The beings of the Tuat shout with joy when you approach, send forth your light upon us, great god who has fire in your eye. Their food consists of loaves of bread and green herbs, and their drink is of the Kemtet plants, and their cool water is from their cisterns. The food shall be given to them in abundance from this lake. The first group shows us what Tam has done for Ra, and how he has protected the god by words of magical power, and has overthrown the serpent Seba. You are prostrate, and shall never more rise, you are enchanted by, and shall never more be found. The word of my father is Maud against you, and my word is Maud against you. I have destroyed you for Ra, and I have made an end of you for Kuti. Your head is slit, Apep, your folds are gashed, you shall never more envelop the boat of Ra, and you shall never again make a way into the divine bark. A flame of fire goes out against you from the hidden place, and we have condemned you to your dire doom. They live upon the food of Ra, and upon the cakes of Kentamenti. Offerings are made on their behalf upon the earth, and libations of cool water are made to them by the Lord of Food before Ra. You are the gods who possess the life and scepter, and who have mastery over your scepters. Drive back the serpent Seba from Kuti, gash with knives the fowl, and evil serpent Afu. These are the gods who work enchantments on Apep, who open the earth to Ra, and who shut it against Apep in the gates of Kentiamenti. They are those who are in the hidden place, who praise Ra, destroy his enemies, and protect the Great One against the serpent Afu, uttering cries of joy at the overthrow of the enemy of Ra. They live upon the meat of Ra, and on the cakes offered to Kentiamenti. Offerings are made on their behalf upon the earth, and they receive libations through word being Maud and Ament, and holy are they of an arm in their hidden place. They utter cries to Ra, and make lamentation for the great god after he has passed by them, for when he has departed they are enveloped in darkness, and their circle is closed upon them. This great god comes to this gateway, and enters through it, and the gods therein acclaim him. Open the earth, force a way through the Tuat and the region which is above, and dispel our darkness. Hail, Ra, come to us. He who is over this door open to Ra. Open your gate to Ra, unfold your doors to Kuti, that he may send light into the thick darkness, and make his radiance illumine the hidden habitation. This door is shut after this great god has passed through it, and there is a lamentation to those who are in this gateway when they hear this door close upon them. This great god is drawn along by the gods of the Tuat. He journeys in the hidden place, and works in respect to the things which are there. Draw me along, beings of the Tuat. Look upon me, I have created you. Pull with your arms and draw me therewith, and turn aside to the eastern part of heaven, to the habitations which surround Ares, that hidden mountain, the light of which goes among the gods who receive me as I come forth among you into the hidden place. Draw me along, I work on your behalf in the gateway, which cover over the gods of the Tuat. Look upon me, gods, for I strike those who are in their sepulchres. Arise, gods. I have ordered for you the plan and manner of your existence, who are in your sepulchres, whose souls are broken, who live upon your filth and feed upon your offal. Rise before my disk, and put yourselves in a right state through my beams. The duties which you shall have in the Tuat conform with the things which I have decreed for you. Their food consists of flesh, and their ale is of the red barley, their libations are of cool water. There is a lamentation after they have heard their doors close upon them. They who stand upon their lake, and guide Ra in a straight line using their instruments. Hearken, goddesses of the hours of the night sky. Work, eat, and rest in your gateways, with your breasts towards the darkness, and your hind parts towards the light. Make to stand up the serpent Heret, and live upon that which come forth from it. It is your duty in the Tuat to eat up the spawn of Heret, and destroy that which come forth from it. Draw me, for I have begotten you so that you may pay homage. Take your rest hours. Their food consists of cakes of bread, and their ale is of the red barley, their draughts are of cool water, and there is given to them as their food that which come forth with the coup. They who bear along with their doubles, immersing themselves in that which flow in abundance from the slaughtered during the time of their existence, and carry the offerings which are rightly due to his abode. That which belong to you, gods, who are among your offerings, is to offer as an obligatory offering your doubles. You have your offerings, your enemies are destroyed, and they are not. Your spirits are on their thrones, souls in their places. Adorations to Ra Kuti. Hail to thee, your soul whom are protected in the earth. Hail to you, as being eternity, the Lord of the years, and of the everlastingness, which has no diminution. Their food consists of offerings, their drink is of cool water, and there is a lamentation when they hear their doors close upon them. Their food is given to them from the goddess Musta by Tezzert Bayu. They who come forth from this lake where the souls of the dead cannot approach, because of the sanctity which is therein. That which belong to you, gods who are in this lake, is to keep guard upon your life in your lake. Your offerings are under the guard of the jackals which have set themselves on the edge of your lake. Immerse yourself raw in the holy lake, where the Lord of the gods immersed himself, where the souls of the dead do not approach. This is what you have commanded Kuti. Their food consists of bread, their drink is of the red barley, and their vessels of drink are filled with wine. There is lamentation among them when they hear their doors close upon them. Their food is given to them as lords of their scepters round about this lake. They who have their speech after Ra comes to them, and souls are turned backward, and shadows are destroyed at the hearing of the words of the Uri. That which belong to you, Uri, who are in this lake, is to guard your flames and your fires, so that you may hurl them against my enemies, and your burning heat against those whose mouths are evil. Hail to you, Uri. Come to us, stride over Tannin. Horus works on behalf of his father Osiris. He performs magical ceremonies for him, and restore to him the crown. My heart goes out to my father, whom are avenged on those who would work against you, and in all the matters which concerned you are guided by magical ceremonies. You have the mastery, Osiris, you have sovereignty, Kenti Amenti, you have whatever is yours as governor of the Tuat, whose forms are exalted in the hidden place. The beautified spirits hold you in fear, and the dead are terrified. Your crown has been restored to you, and I, your son Horus, have reckoned your weakness there. Let him of the Tuat be exalted. Let Kenti Amenti be adored. Your son Horus has restored to you your crown. He has protected you employing magical ceremonies. He has crushed for you your enemies. He has brought to you vigor for your arms, Osiris, Kentiamenti. Come to me, my son Horus, and avenge me on those who work against me, and cast them to him that is over the things which destroy. It is he who guard the pits. Make inquisition for me, gods who are in the following of Kentiamenti. Stand up, withdraw not yourselves, be masters over yourselves. Come live delicately on the bread of Hu, drink of the ale of Mott, and live upon that where my father live. That which belonged to you in the hidden place is to be behind the shrine, according to the commandment of Ra. I call unto you and behold, it is for you to do what it is your duty. Their meat consists of cakes of bread, and their ale is of the Chesert drink, and their libations are cool water. Their food is given to them by the guardian of the things which are in the shrine. Smite the enemies of my father and hurl them down into your pits, because of that deadly evil which they have done against the Great One, him that begot me. That which belongs to you to do in the Tuat is to guard the pits of fire according to what Ra has commanded, and I set before you so that, behold, you may do according to what belongs to you. This god stands over the pits. This great god comes to this gateway, and enters in through it, and the gods who therein acclaim him. Ra-Hur-Kuti unfolds our doors, and open our gateways. Hail, Ra, come to us, great god, lord of hidden nature. He who is over this door open to Ra. Sa says to Tikara, open your gate to Ra, unfold your doors to Kuti, that he may send light into the thick darkness, and may make his radiance illumine the hidden habitation. This door is shut after the great god has passed through it, and there is a lamentation to those who are in this gateway, when they hear this door close upon them. The gods of the Tuat draw along this great god, and he journeys through the hidden place. Draw me along, gods of the Tuat, and sing praises to me, you who are at the head of the stars. Let your cords be strong, and draw me along employing them, and let your hands and arms be steady. Let there be speed in your legs, let there be strong intent in our souls, and let your hearts be glad. Open a prosperous way into the chambers of hidden things. Carry this serpent. Ra strikes them and advances towards them to make himself to rest in Nenehau. This serpent travels as far as this gateway, but he passes not beyond it. Strike the serpent Anechi there, give him no way, so that I may pass by you. Hide your arms, destroy that which you guard, protect that which comes into being from my forms, and tie up that which comes into being from my strength. Their food consists of the hearing of the word of this god, and offerings are made to them from the hearing of the word of Ra in the Tuat. Unto those who have spoken what is right and true upon the earth, and who have magnified the forms of the god, praises shall be to your souls, and there shall be breath to your nostrils, and there shall be to your joints in Sekhetaru. That which shall be indeed yours is what belonged to the mighty gods. The habitations which shall be yours shall be at the corner where those who are with me who weigh words for them. Their food is of bread cakes, and their drink of Chesert drink, and their libations are of cool water. Offerings are made to them upon the earth as to the god Hedepi, according to what should be offered to them. Let him that is over his corner cry out to those souls who are right, and true, and divine, and make them sit at peace in their habitations at the corner of those who are with me. They who make songs to Ra in Amentet, and exalt Hur-Kuti. New Ra upon the earth, and who made offerings unto him. Their offerings are in their place, and their glory is in the holy place of Ament. Come Ra, progress through the Tuat. Praise be to you. Enter among the holy with the serpent Mehen. There are offerings for you, who made offerings. I am content with what you did for me, both when I used to shine in the eastern part of heaven, and when I was sinking to rest in the chamber of my eye. Their food is of the bread cakes of Ra, and their drink is of his cheeser drink, and their libations are made of cool water, and offerings are made unto them on the earth for the praisings which they make to Ra in Ament. These are the ones who hold the measuring cord in Ament, and they go over there with the fields of the Ku. Take the cord, draw it tight, and mark out the limit of the fields of Amentet, the Ku, whereof, are in your abodes, and the gods, whereof, are on your thrones. The Ku of Maturity are in the field of peace, Each coup has been judged by him that is in the cord. Righteousness is to those who are, and unrighteousness to those who are not. What is right is the cord in aiment, and Ra is content with the stretching of the same. Your possessions are yours, gods, your homesteads are yours, Khu. Behold, Ra make your fields, and he commands on your behalf that there may be sand with you. Hail, journey on, Khuti, the gods are content with that which they possess, and the Khu are content with their homesteads. Their food comes from Sekhetaru, their offerings from that which spring up therein. Offerings are made to them upon the earth from the estate of Sekhetaru. Holy are you, Henbai gods, overseers of the cords in Amentet. Establish your fields and give to the gods and the Khu after they have been measured in Sekhetaru. Let them give fields and sand to the gods and to the souls who are in the Tuat. Their food shall be from Sekhetaru, and their offerings from the things which spring forth therein. Horus says to the creatures of Ra who dwell in the black land, and in the red land, magical protection be unto you, you creatures of Ra, who have come into being from the Great One who is at the head of heaven. Let there be breath to your nostrils, and let your linen swathing be unloosened. You are the tears of the eye of my splendor in your name of Reth. Mighty of the Ishi, you have come into being in your name of Amu. Sekhet has created them, and it is she who delivered their souls. I masturbated, and I was content with the hundreds of thousands who came forth from me in your name of Nahisu. Horus made them come into being, and it is he who avenges their souls. I sought out my eye, and you came into being in your name of Themhu. Sekhet has created them, and she avenges their souls. Those who make firm the duration of life establish the days of the souls in Amenti, and possess the word of the place of destruction. Since you are the gods who dwell in the Tuat, who have possession of Metarui, utilizing whom you mete out the duration of life of the souls who are in Amenti, who are condemned to destruction, destroy the souls of the enemies according to the place of destruction which you are commanded to appoint, and let them not see the hidden place. Divine sovereign chiefs who shall destroy the enemies. They shall have their offerings through the word Mot. They shall have their oblations upon the earth using the word Mot, and it is they who destroy, and who pass the edict concerning the duration of the life of the souls who dwell in Amenti. The destruction which is yours shall be against the enemies, and the power to write which you possess shall be for the place of destruction. I have come, even I the Great One Horus, that I may make a reckoning with my body, and that I may shoot forth evils against my enemies. Their food is bread, and their drink is the Chesert wine, and they have cool water to refresh themselves. Offerings are made to them upon the earth. One does not enter into the place of destruction. This god comes forth to this pylon, and he passes through it, and those gods who are in the secret place acclaim him. Come to us, you who are at the head of the horizon, great god, who opens the hidden place. Open the holy doors, and unfold the portals of the hidden place. His enemies are under his feet, the gods and the spirits are before him. He is the enemy of the dead among the beings of the Tuat. Osiris puts under restraint enemies, he destroys them, and perform the slaughter of them. Hail, you who make to be Mot the word of your little one. May Thoth weigh the words. May he make to eat his father. This god enters, he rises and put under restraint Amah. The balance bearer does homage, the blessed spirits in Amenti follow after him. The morning star disperses the thick darkness, there is goodwill above, justice below. The god reposes himself, he gives bread to the blessed, who throng toward him. The bearer of the hatchet and the bearer of the scales protect the inhabitant of Amenti, takes his repose in Hades and traverses the darkness and the shadows. Happiness is above, and justice below. The god reposes and sheds light produced by the truth which he has produced. They hide those which are in the state of the elect. They the country belonging to them, is a may in the land. Behold, these are they whose heads issue. What a mystery is their appearance of your images. The examination of the words takes place, and he strikes down wickedness. He who has a just heart, he who bears the words in the scales, in the divine place of the examination of the mystery of mysteries of the spirits. The god who rises has made his infernal all. He who is over this door open to Ra. Sa says to Set Emma F. Open your gate to Ra, unfold your doors to Kuti, that he may send light into the thick darkness, and may make his radiance illumine the hidden habitation. This door is shut after this great god has passed through it, and there is a lamentation to those who are in this gateway when they hear this door close upon them. This great god is towed along by the gods in the Tuat, and those who tow Ra along say, "Rise, O Disk, God, go forth to the standards of Seb." Ham says to the standards, "Keep ward over the enemies, and bind fast those who shall be smitten." Gods who are behind the standards, and who are in the following of Seb, I give you the power to bind fast the enemies, and to keep ward over the wicked. Let them not go forth from under your hands, let them not slip through your fingers. Enemies, you are reckoned for slaughter according to the decree which was given to you by He who created the Tuat with His body, and His members. He has passed the decree for you to be punished, and He takes count of you, and what you do. They who have offered up incense to the gods, and whose doubles have been washed, Mot, they have been reckoned up, and they are Mot in the presence of the great god, who destroy iniquities. Osiris says to them, "You are Mot of Mot. Be at peace for what you have done, who are in the forms of those who are in my following, and who dwell in the house of him whose souls are holy. Live on what you live, and have the mastery over the cool waters in your lake. Perform work with the grain, and embrace the god of wheat, which is eaten. Their grain becomes glorious in the land through the light of Ra, when he appears, and send forth heat, and makes his way by them." The Lord of the Joy of Heart says to them, "Let your grain be glorious, and let the young shoots of your grain germinate, let your offerings be for Ra. Let Meeper germinate, and let Sar be the source of food of the gods in the Tuat, in the fields of the Tuat." They gather together their grain, and they say unto Ra, "Let the fields of the Tuat be green with young plants. May Ra shine upon the members of Sar. When you shine, the young plants come into being, great God, creator of the grain. Their offerings of food are of grain, and their drink offerings are of cheeser, and their libations are made with cool water. Offerings are made to them on the earth of the grain of the fields of the Tuat. They who have their scythes, and who reaps the grain in their fields." Ra says to them, "Take your scythes, and reap your grain, for it is granted to you in your habitations. Join yourselves to me in the circle of the hidden forms. Hail to you, reapers! Their food is of bread, and their drink is of cheeser, and their libations are made with cool water. Offerings are made to them upon the earth as being those who hold scythes in the fields of the Tuat. This great god is being towed along by the gods of the Tuat, and those who tow Ra along say, Be exalted, Aten, who are at the head of the light. Look at the abodes of the Tuat. Your eyes are to you gods, observe Ra, the power in Akert. This great god decrees your destinies. This great god comes forth to the standards of Seb, which reckon up the enemies after the weighing of words in Amentet. Behold, Sa says to this god when he comes forth to the standards of Seb, The head of Ra, the great god, go forth to the standards of Seb. Hem says to the standards, Keep ward over the enemies, and bind those who are to be smitten. Gods who are in the following of the standards, and who are in the following of Seb, I give you the power to bind fast the enemies, and keep ward over the wicked. Let them not come forth from under your hands, let them not slip through your fingers. Enemies are doomed to slaughter according to the decree of Ra concerning you. His person is the body of Akert, and he has created the Tuat of his framework. He has issued the decree for you to be put into restraint. He has ordered your doom, which shall be wrought upon you in the great hall of Ra. The gods weep and lament, he sets the gods toward you, and the enemies, and those who are to be smitten in the Tuat are condemned to these standards. Offerings of incense to their gods, libations of cool water to their doubles, and filling of the mouth by his sustenance afterward by their offerings of drink, and their offerings of bread. Come forth to them their gods and their doubles. Their hands are to them, and they go to their cakes through the pylon, and to its gods. Sar says to them, Your bread is to you, according to your utterances, and the peace cakes of Keeper, and loaves of bread. You shall have the mastery over your legs, satisfaction in your hearts, and your gods shall present to you your kenficakes, and to your doubles, their provisions, which consist of bread, and their drink, which shall be of cheese or ale, their libations shall be of cool water, and offerings shall be made to them upon the earth as the lords of offerings in Amentet. They have done what was right while they were upon the earth, and they have fought on behalf of their God, and they shall be called to the enjoyment of the land of the house of life with Mont. That which is theirs by right shall be allotted to them in the presence of the great God, who does away iniquity. Then shall Osiris say to them, Mot be to you, Mot gods, and peace be to you because of what you have done in following after me, dwellers in the house the soul of which is holy. You shall live your life upon that whereupon those who live there feed, and you shall have dominion over the cool waters of your land. I have decreed for you that you shall have your being in all of it with Mot, and without sin. Their bread shall be Mot cakes, their drink shall be of wine, and their libations shall be of cool water. There shall be offered to them upon earth the offerings, which must be made from their land. They perform their work with the grain, they embrace the divine grain, and the spirits feed upon their grain in the land of the God of Light, who comes forth and pass by them, and Nebarib says to them, Let your grain be glorious, and let your ears of wheat germinate, and let your offerings be for Ra. Your kinfia cakes are in the Tuat, your offerings are to you, the offerings which are yours by Mot are decreed for you. Herbs among you Sar germinates, and they say unto Ra, Let plants spring up in the fields of the Tuat, and let Ra shine upon the members of Sar. When you shine the young plants come into being, great God, creator of the egg. Their food offerings are of grain, their drink is of cheese or ale, and their libations are made with cool water. Offerings are made to them upon earth of the grain from the fields of the Tuat. These are they who have their sickles, and who reap the grain in their field. Ra says to them, Take your sickles, and reap your grain, for it is granted to you in your habitations, join yourselves to the circle of the hidden of forms. Hail to you, reapers! Their food is of bread cakes, and their drink is of cheese or ale, and their libations are made with cool water. Offerings are made to them upon the earth as being those who reap the grain in the fields of the Tuat. The majesty of this great God takes up his abode in the hall of Osiris, and the majesty of this God addresses words to the hall of the gods who dwell therein. This God performs all the rites proper this hall, and he advances against Apep by means of the words of power of Isis, and of the words of power of the sovereign God. The name of the gate of this city wherethrough passes this God is Rudiasar. The name of this city is Thefetsheda. The name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god into it is Keftzahesketnehara. Behind the god stand Heruvikin, Kashu, Nehes, Hu, and the protector of the boat. This great god journeys in this city in the path of the circle of Sar by the utterances of the words of power of Isis, and the words of power of Ser, so that he may journey on his way against Nehara. If these words of power of Isis and Ser be uttered, Apep shall be turned back, and shut up in Ament, in the hidden place of the Tuat. If they be uttered on the earth it shall be so likewise. Whosoever shall utter them shall become one of those who are in the boat of Ra, both in heaven and upon earth. But whosoever knows not these figures shall not know how to repulse Nehara. He who is Apep, and he surrounds his country, which is in the Tuat. Chow is the name of this district, which is 440 cubits in length, and 440 cubits in breadth, and his voice guides the gods to him. He who is with him after this great god has made his passage through this city, halts with Afu, opposite to the country whereover he would make a way. Behold, Circuit is at the head, and Hertesuef places his deadly fetter about his feet after Isis has taken possession of the words of power of Seraph twofold strength, and Ra gives their words of power. Whosoever knows it upon earth shall not be one of those of whose water Nehara drinks. The goddesses who hack at Apep in the Tuat, who repulse the affairs of the enemies of Ra, hold knives, and hack asunder Apep in the Tuat each day. Hidden magical figures of the Tuat, the funeral shrines of the hidden heads. The hidden heads appear, and when they have heard the voice of Ra they eat their own forms, after this great god has passed them by. The hidden road of Ament. The great god makes his way over it in his holy boat. and he passes over this road which has no water, and none to tow. He makes his way by means of the words of power of Isis, Semsu, and the utterances of this great god himself. Magical protectors, that perform the slaughters of Apep and Metuit, in this circle in his windings in the sky. Whosoever shall make an image according to the similitudes, which are in writing at the northern side of the hidden palace in the Tuat, they shall act for him as magical protectors in heaven and in earth. Whosoever know them shall be as the spirits with Ra. The majesty of this great and holy God says, grant me to come forth on the path by your spittle, your throat. Let me utter the word which is Mat to Ankhit, and let me open your fold, for I have come to illumine the darkness, and to embrace him that is in Mehen. This god says to Osiris, who dwells in the serpent Mehen, hail, Osiris, governor of the Tuat, lord of life, ruler of Amentet, you shall live your life, you have magical power, and shall prevail by magical power in this land. You exalt those who are in your following on their arrival before you. Your enemies are beneath your feet, you have gained the mastery over those who have worked against you. The flames are against them, he burns them up with his blazing knife, which is over them, hacks them in pieces, chops them up with his slaughtering knife, and he reckons up his members each day. Let me pass over you in peace. The majesty of this god says, spirits who are hostile to Osiris, who have rebelled against the governor of the Tuat, your hands and arms are fettered, and are tied tightly with bonds, your souls are kept under ward, your shades are hacked in pieces, Ankle has drawn the cords about you tightly, and you shall never be able to escape from his restraint. The work of this figure who is in the Tuat, is to send the stars and hours on their way in the Tuat. The majesty of Horus of the Tuat says to the starry gods, you who are Mat in your flesh, whose magical powers have come into being for you, who are united to your stars, who yourselves rise up for Ra in the horizon which is in the Tuat each day, be in his following, and let your stars guide his two hands so that he may journey through the beautiful Ament in peace. You gods who stand up, who dwell in our land, light up your stars in the sky so that I may unite with the master of the horizon. The majesty of Harutuwadi says to the hours who are in this city, hours who have the power of coming into being, are endowed with stars, who avenge Ra, fight on behalf of him that is on the horizon, take our forms, carry your symbols, lift ye up your heads, and guide Ra, who is on the horizon, into the beautiful Amentet in peace. Behold the gods and goddesses who guide this great god along the hidden way of this city. He who is Abshau, is the warden of the symbols of this city. When he hears the voice of the boat of Ra, which is addressed to the eye which is in his cheek, the head which is in his dominion makes its appearance, and then it eats its own form after this great god has passed it by. Whosoever knows Abshau shall not devour his soul. The majesty of this great god takes up its place in the circles of the hidden gods who are on their sand, and he addresses to them words in his boat while the gods tow him along through the city by means of the magical powers of the serpent Mehen. The name of the gate of this city is Aha and Ert-Nef. The name of this city is Tebet-Neteres. The name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god, is Net-Usha. The hidden circles of Ament, which are passed through by the great god, his boat being towed along by the gods who dwell in the Tuat. Let them be made according to the figures on the north of the hidden palace in the Tuat. Whosoever know them by their names shall be the possessor of swathing upon earth, and he shall not be repulsed at the hidden gates, and he shall have offerings in very great abundance regularly and perpetually. This god makes his way into this city, being towed along by the gods of the Tuat, in his hidden form of Mehen. This god sends forth a cry to the regions of every circle of this city, and also to the gods who are therein, and it is the voice of them which this god hears after he has sent forth a cry to them. The figures of their bodies remain always with their dead bodies, which are under their sand, their gates open to the voice of this god each day, and then they hide themselves after he has passed by them. Their work in the Tuat is to tow Ra along over the ways of this city. They rise up after they have towed him along into this hall, and they say to him, come to your hidden image, our god, and to all the sepulchres of Kenti Iamenti, unite yourself strongly to it. May you be entreated to lighten the darkness of those who are on their sands. We beseech you to come and unite yourself, Ra, to those who tow you along. These are the gods of the Tuat who tow alone Ra, in the place where the gods have their sepulchres, and he is acclaimed by those who are in this city. The images secret of Tafinin, of Horus, the gods are with them. Those who are on the path along which this god is towed have their swathing before them in the form in which the god himself had them. This our great god cries out to those who have their life in them, in their heads, in their forms, and this god cries out to them by their names. Their work is to seize the enemies of Ra throughout the city, and then make their heads pass under their swords after this god has passed them by. Those in the Tuat with their swathing of linen in front of them, in the form in which the god himself had them, are they to whom he cries out to after he has come to the place where they are. They cry out to this god with their voices joyful but hidden, and this god sings a song of joy at their voices. After this great god has passed by them, and when the darkness of night has covered them over, they receive the diadems of Ra, and the soul of Tafinin unites itself to the earth. Those who are seated on their instruments for weaving after the manner of Horus, the heir, and youthful one. This god cries out to their souls after he has entered into this city of the gods who are on their sand, and there are heard the voices of those who are shut in this circle, which are like the hum of many bees of honey, when their souls cry out to Ra, the name of this circle is Sashida. Those who are seated upon their instruments for weaving, which are set firmly on their sand, according to the mystery which Horus made. This god cries out to their souls in whatsoever regions they are, and there are heard the voices of those who are shut in this circle which are like the sound of the swathed ones, and their souls cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Tuat. Those who are seated upon their instruments for weaving, which are set firmly on their sand, according to the mystery which Horus made. This god cries out to their souls in whatsoever regions they are, and there is heard the sound of the voices of those who are shut in this circle, which is like the sound of men who lament, when their souls cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Isneteru. Those who are seated upon their instruments for weaving, which are set firmly on their sand, according to the mystery which Horus made. This god cries out to their souls in whatsoever regions they are, and there is heard the sound of the voices of those who are shut in this circle, which is like the sounds of bulls and other male animals when their souls cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Akibi. Those who are seated upon their instruments for weaving, which are set firmly on their sand, according to the mystery which Horus made. This god cries out to their souls in whatsoever regions they are, and there is heard the sound of the voices of those who are shut in this circle, which is like the sound of those who make supplication through terror when their souls cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Netsi-Ninifu. Those who are seated upon their instruments for weaving, which are set firmly on their sand, according to the mystery which Horus made, the heir, the young god made. This great god cries out to their souls after he has entered into this city of the gods who are upon their sand, and when this god cries out to them in the Tuaturti there is heard the sound of those who are shut in this circle, which is like the voices of male cats when they cry out, and their souls cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Hedepet Nebes. Those who are seated upon their instruments for weaving, which are set firmly on their sand, according to the mystery which Horus made. This god cries out to their souls, in whatsoever regions they are in the Tuaturti, and there is heard the sound of the voices of those who are shut in this circle, which is like the sound of the confused murmur of the living when their souls cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Hetmet-Kemil. Those who have their instruments for weaving before them, and are set firmly on their sand, according to the mystery which Horus made. This god cries out to their souls, in whatsoever regions they are in the Tuaturti, and there is heard the sound of the voices of those who are shut in this circle, which is like the sound of the voices of those who go down to the battlefield of Nu when their souls cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Hapsinus. Those who have their instruments of weaving before them, and are set firmly on their sand, according to the mystery which Horus made. This god cries out to their souls in whatsoever regions they are in the Tuaturti, and there is heard the sound of voices of those who are shut in this circle, which is like the sound of the cry of the divine hawk of horns when their souls cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Sehert Bayus. those who are seated on their instruments of weaving, and are set firmly on their sand. This God cries out to them in whatsoever regions they are, and they shed light by means of their radiance from the depth of their mouths, but they do not come forth from their circle, and there is heard the sound of the voices of those who are shut in this circle, which is like the twittering of a nest of waterfowl when they cry out to Ra. The name of this circle is Tzedakah. This great God takes up his place in this circle, and he addresses words from his boat to those who are in it. The divine sailors join the boat of this great God in this city. The name of the gate of this city through which this God enters, and takes up his place on the stream, which is in this city is Sa'em-Keb. The name of the city is Bestaru-Enket-Keperu. The name of the hour of the night, which guide this great God is Tuatet-Mektet and Nebebes. The hidden circle of Amentet, through which this great God travels, and takes up his place in the Tuat. If these things be made with their names after the manner of this figure, which is depicted at the east of the hidden house of the Tuat, and if a man know their names while he is on earth, know their places in Amenti, he shall attain his own place in the Tuat, and he shall stand up in all places which belong to the gods whose voices are Maat, even as the divine sovereign chiefs of Ra, and the mighty ones of the palace, and shall be a benefit to him on earth. This great God joins those who will transport him through the city, and his sailors join his boat wherein he is in his hidden form of Mehen. This great God addresses words to the gods who dwell in this city, to the gods who are the sailors of the boat of Ra, and to those who will transport him through the horizon, so that he may take up his position in the eastern hall of heaven. Their work in the Tuat is to transport Ra through this city every day, and they take their stand by the stream in this city on the boat, and it is they who give water with their paddles to the spirits who are in this city, and they sing hymns to the Lord of the Disk, and they make to arise his soul in his forms by means of their hidden words every day. Those who are in this city are they who give offerings of food to the gods who are in the Tuat. Ra decrees for them loaves of bread and vessels of beer, and the gods journey on in the following of this great God to the eastern horizon of the sky, with Hetep-Neteru Tuat following him. Those who are seated firmly on their instruments for weaving, and are in the form of the figures which Horus made. Ra says to them, "You who are in your holy swathing, who are arrayed in your garments, whom Horus covered up when he hid his father in the Tuat, which concealed the gods, uncover your heads, unveil your faces, and perform the things which must be done for Osiris. Ascribe your praise to the Lord of Amentet, and make your word Maat against his enemies every day. These beings are the chacha of this god, and they avenge by their words Osiris each day, and the work they do in the Tuat is to overthrow the enemies of Osiris. Those with their bodies of the Tuat are they who are in the forms which Horus made. This great god cries out to them after he has arrived at the place where they are, and they come to life and they hear his voice. Their work in the Tuat is to raise the praises of Osiris, and to embrace the hidden soul by means of their words, bring life, strength to the risings of the god of the Tuat, and they utter words on his behalf in the chamber each day. The names of the Urii who kindle fires for the god, who is the governor of the Tuat, by means of the fire which is in their mouths. They swallow their flames after this god has passed by them. Those who are in the Tuat have bodies of fire, and lighten the darkness in the Tuat for Osiris, by means of the flames which come from their mouths. It is they who bring about the destruction of those who are overthrown in the Tuat. It is they who drive back the serpents of every kind which are on the ground, and are unknown in their forms to the god of the Tuat. They make themselves to live by means of the blood of those whom they hack to pieces each day, when those advance who endow with magical power the dead by the mystery of their formulae. Those who know this shall see their magical formulae, and shall not pass through their flames. This great god takes up his place in this circle, and he utters words to the gods who dwell therein. The name of the door of this city through which this great god enters is Akherpamesaru. The name of this city is Metet Ka'achibo. The name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god to the hidden paths of this city, is Tentanet Yehit Ka'kabu. This great god makes his journey through the city, in his boat, and his sailors, who are the gods, convey him along, this god takes up his place in the city in the water, whereupon those who live in the water make use of their weapons, and spring into life at the sound of the working of the sailors, who are gods. Those who are on the two sides of Bes Rau, the soil of Sekri, the governor of Fatuat. This figure, even in the form in which it is, travels after this great god into its horizon, and it enters in with him in the earth every day. He who is in his boat stands up in the thick darkness in the hall of the eastern horizon, and takes up his position in his place every day. He forms the serpent watcher of the Tuat in the holy place of Kentiamenti. To those who are with their arrows, javelins, and bows, who are in the presence of this great god, and who make their appearance with him in the eastern horizon of the sky, this great god says, "Speed your arrows, make ready your javelins, bend your bows, and destroy for me my enemies who are in darkness, be at the portal of your horizon, and follow in my train when I unite myself to those who make adoration to my flesh in the mantid boat. It is they who drive back the Sebi serpent of Neha-Ra in the thick darkness, and when this great god passes on into the eastern hall of the horizon, they also travel on in the train of this god. The hidden circle of Amentet, where Keeper unites himself to the form of Ra, where the gods, the spirits, and the dead hasten in the hidden forms of Akert. If a copy of these things be made according to the figures which are depicted on the east of the hidden chamber of the Tuat, and if a man know it, together with the names of the gods, he shall journey and pass through the Tuat, and not be turned back from making himself a companion of Ra. Those who are in the forms of the births of the god Keeper, who is carrying his horizon to this city, so that he may come forth into the eastern horizon of the sky. Those who are the two goddesses on the left come forth from the double serpent Menenui, and on the right come forth from the axe Setfit. They gather together the souls on earth. They make pure the mighty spirits in the Tuat by the hidden figures which are therein, and they swallow their own spirits after this great god has passed them by. To these goddesses who make the reckoning of his eye for Horus in the Tuat, Ra says, "Make strong your spirits by means of strength, make the reckoning of his eye for Horus, establish his eye for Horus, make Horus unite himself to his emanation, praise Horus by reason of his eye, establish his first eye which is in the hands of the god Af-Ermin-Mat-Ef, and utter your words on behalf of Horus, you who cause to come into being the becoming of created things. The work which they do in the Tuat is to utter words on behalf of his eye for Horus, and to cause radiant splendor to proceed from it each day. Those who are in the forms which Horus made when this great god cries out to them by their names, they unite themselves, and come into life in the shades which are in the mouth of the great god, and their souls journey onwards in his train to the horizon. They strip the bodies of the dead of their swathing and break in pieces the bodies of the enemies, and order their destruction in the Tuat. Horus says to those who have plunged themselves beneath the waters, to swim, and float in new of the Tuat, you who have plunged yourselves beneath the waters, who shine in new, whose hands cover your faces, who swim with your faces turned towards the water in the Tuat, whose cheeks are filled with water, who paddle in the waters of new, whose faces are turned up into the air in the following of your souls, whose souls have been deprived of their heavenly air, and who beat the air with your hands. In order to obtain it, make your way new by means of your legs, and your thighs shall not be impeded. Come forth in this stream, descend on these waves, fill Hapur, arrive at its furrows, for your members shall not perish, your flesh shall not decay, you shall have dominion over your water, abundance according to my command, you whose duty it is to dwell in new, together with those who have plunged themselves beneath the waters, are in following, and whose souls have life. Those who are they whose forms live by their heads. It is they who shed light upon the road of Ra in the thick darkness, and when he comes forth into the hall of the east, Set wakes up and travels on with him. The majesty of this great god takes up his position in this circle, and he addresses words to the gods who are in it. The name of the gate of this city through which this great god has entered is Sekhintuashu. The name of this city is Re-Enkerit-Apt-Kadu. The name of the hour of the night, which guide this great god is Sebit-Net-Wakesvit-Seba-Emperdef. This great god journeys on his way in the city, and his sailors, who are the gods, guide him into the eastern horizon of the sky. The star Pistet, which is on its boat, guides this great god into the ways of the darkness, which gradually lightens and illumine those who are on the earth. Those who are in front of this great god, and carry the serpent Mehenta on their heads into this city, travel onwards in the following of Ra into the eastern horizon of the sky. This god cries to them by their names, and he decrees for them what they have to do, and Ra says to them, "You who keep ward over your serpent figures with your two hands, lift up your heads, whose hands and feet are strong and firm, perform the journeyings which you are bound to make, make long your steps as you go, and unite yourselves to your offerings in the hall of the eastern horizon." Their work is to make the serpent Mehen to travel to the eastern hall of the horizon, and they unite themselves to their habitations after this great god has passed through the darkness and has taken up his place in the horizon. The hidden images of Horus, which are at the second door of the thick darkness, the holy road to Sate. When this great god cries out to them, these hidden heads make their appearance, and then they swallow their own forms. Those who are in the form which Horus made, when this god cries out to them by their names, they spring into life at the sound of his voice, and it is they who guard the holy gate of the city of Sate, which is unknown, and cannot be seen, and cannot be looked at. The hidden circle of the Tuat through which this god makes his journey, so that he may come forth into the eastern horizon of the sky, it swallows eternally its images in the presence of the god Rek, who dwells in this city, and then it gives them to those who are born and come into being in the earth. Whosoever shall make an exact copy of these forms according to the representations at the eastern portion of the hidden palace of the Tuat, and shall know it, shall be a spirit well equipped both in heaven and earth, unfailingly, regularly and eternally. He who stands up for Ra, and never departs from his place in the Tuat. When this god cries out to him, the form of the god Tem proceed from his back, but afterwards it swallows itself. Chedes herself is above the stars. Her work is to cast the living ones to Ra every day. She then swallows her forms in the city of the 11th hour, and she is one of those who follow the god. Those who this great god call by their names, saying, "My hidden appearances and my secret radiance cause your life, you who advance to your shadows, are free to move, or are shrouded in respect of the arms by the form in his holy places, whose breaths are of the utterances of my mouth, which give life, and you speak therewith, whose offerings are on my boat whereon your souls live, who have water at the source of new wherein the dwellers in the Tuat wash, with shouts of joy, perform that which it is your right to do, and let your souls be in the following of created things." Their work in the Tuat is to advance the hidden things of this great god to the hidden house each day, when they appear with this great god in the upper heaven. Those who have their arms on the earth, and their feet and legs in the darkness, when this great god cries to them in their own bodies, they utter cries, they do not depart from their places, but their souls live in the word of the forms which come forth from their feet every day. When the shades appear, the winds which are in the Tuat cease from the faces of these goddesses. The majesty of this god utters the decree, "Hack in pieces, and cut asunder the bodies of the enemies, and the members of the dead who have been turned upside down. My father, having been helpless, has smitten you, cut up your bodies, hacked in pieces your spirits, your souls, scattered in pieces your shadows, and cut in pieces your heads. You shall never more exist. You shall be overthrown, and cast down headlong into the pits of fire. You shall not escape therefrom or be able to flee from the flames which are in the serpent Setheth. The fire of Hurt Ketetes, the flames of Hurt Hatues, the blazing heat of Hurt Nemetes, and Hurt Sefues is against you. She stabs at you, and hacks you in pieces, cuts you up in such ways that you shall never again see those who are living upon the earth. As for those who are in the Tuat, it is the majesty of Herutuati who gives the order for their slaughter each day. Those who are with the enemies of Osiris of the Tuat, and with her Utuef, who is the guardian of this circle, live by means of the voice of the enemies, and by the cries of entreaty of the souls and shadows which have been placed in their pits of fire. The majesty of this great god takes up his position in this circle, which is the uttermost limit of thick darkness. This great god is born in his form of Kepra in this circle. Nut and Nu are in this circle for the birth of this great god when he comes forth from the Tuat and takes up his position in the Metet boat, when he rises up from the thighs of Nut. The name of the gate of this city is Ben Neteru. The name of this city is Keeper Kiki Akau Mestu. The name of the hour of the night wherein this god comes into being is Manafert Ra. The hidden circle in the Tuat wherein this great god is born, he comes forth into the pool of Nu, and he takes up his place in the body of Nut. Whosoever shall make a copy thereof according to the copies which exist in writing on the east of the palace, and shall know it upon earth, it shall act as a magical protector for him both in heaven and upon earth. This great god journeys along through this city by means of the faithful servants of this hidden image Ankh Neteru. His gods draw him along by a cord, and he enters into his tail, and comes forth from his mouth, comes to the birth under the form of Kepra, and the gods who are in his boat likewise. He takes up his place on the face of the hidden image of the horn of the sky at the end of the thick darkness, and his hands seal up the Tuat. Then this great god takes up his position in the eastern horizon of heaven, Shu receives him, and he comes into being in the east. Those who draw this great god through the tail of the serpent Ankh Neteru. The loyal servants of Ra who are in his following are the product of his hands, and are born on the earth each day after the birth of this great god in the eastern portion of the sky. They enter into this hidden image of Ankh Neteru in the form of loyal servants, and come forth in the renewed forms of Ra every day. When they are on the earth, it is an abomination to them to utter the name of the god. Those who are here are they who have their bodies, and come forth in the following of this great god into heaven. This is the hidden image of the serpent Ankh Neteru, which is by his den in the Tuat, and he rests in his place every day. This great god speaks to him in his name of Na. His forepaws and legs is 1,300 cubits long. He lives upon the sound of the rumblings of the earth. The servants who are loyal to his service come forth from his mouth every day. Those who take the towing rope of the boat of Ra, when it cometh forth from the serpent Ankh Neteru, tow this great god into the sky, and lead him along the ways of the upper sky. They make to arise in the sky gentle winds and humid breezes. They order those who live upon earth to place themselves in the great boat in the sky. Those with their own bodies, from whom their uriah emerge, are in the following of this great god when he sets out for this city. They follow after this god, and flames which issue from their mouths drive away a pep on behalf of Ra into the hall of the east of the horizon. They journey the upper heavens in his following in their places. They restore these gods after this great god has passed by the hidden chamber of the sky, and then they take up their positions in their own abodes. They give pleasure to the hearts of the gods of Amentet through Ra Hurukkut. Their work upon the earth is to drive away those who are in the darkness by the flames of their uriah, which are behind them, and they guide Ra long, and they smite a pep for him in the sky. Those who sing praises to this great god from dawn, when he takes up his position in the hall of the east of the sky. They say unto Ra, you who are the producer of birth, who brings into being your own being, lord of homage of every soul. Heaven belongs to your soul, which takes up its place therein, and the earth belongs to your body, lord of homage. Your sails over the horizon, takes up your place in your shrine, the gods in their bodies praise you, descend into the sky, and take your two souls through magical protectors. The work of these gods in the Tuat is to praise this great god. They stand in the city, and they count up the gods of the country of Mafkit. They descend to earth before Ra after he has taken up his position in the sky, and rise upon the eyes of mankind in their circles. Those who are in their own bodies join themselves to Ra in the sky to receive this great god at his coming forth among them in the east of the sky each day. They themselves belong to their halls of the horizon, but the forms which they have in the Tuat belong to this circle. Those with their paddles drive a pep to the back of the sky, after the birth of the god. Their work is to hold up the great disk in the eastern horizon of the sky every day. Behold the serpent Senmekef which burns the enemies of Ra at the dawn. These gods go about the heights of heaven in the following of this great god every day, and they receive their protection for this circle. Those who are behind the image of Osiris, over the thick darkness are the words which this god say to them after this great god has journeyed by it. Life to you, who are over the darkness. Life to you in all your majesty. Life to you, governor of Amentet, Osiris, who are over the beings of Amentet. Life to you. Life to you. You who are over the Tuat, the winds of Ra are to your nostrils, and the nourishment of Keeper is with you. You live, and they live. Hail to Osiris, the lord of the living gods who are with Osiris, and who came into being with him the first time. Those who are behind this hidden image in this circle wherein he live have their nourishment from the words of this god and their own Tuat. He who in the invisible form of Horus in the thick darkness is the hidden image which Shu lifts up beneath the sky, and Kebur comes forth in the earth in this image.
Watch us on YouTube and Facebook at The Strange, Bizarre, Unusual, I Like It. Listen to our podcast on any of these platforms: Anchor, Breaker, Google Podcasts, Overcast, Pocket Casts, Radio Public, Spotify. Support us on Patreon. Thanks for stopping by. We thank you for your participation. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, share, make comments. We love feedback.